darkness, man of God, and he carried you into the kingdom of his dear son. That is enough to shout and bless the Lord. But as we live for him today, whether you just came in or you've been in the church 20 or 30 or 40 years now, there's some question that you must ask yourself. When you ask those questions, not only should you ask those questions, but you should know the answers to these questions. First of all, you must know and ask yourself, whose am I? Amen. Because when you come to Jesus, you belong to him. When you ask yourself that question, I don't know about you, but I just want to be real this morning. I, Terrence Felix Moore, born on the 30th of July, 1966, after I was given birth by my mother, I found a new birth in Jesus. So I was bought with a price, the precious blood of Jesus. So now I no more belong to my mother. I belong to the Son of God who loved me and gave his life for me. Amen. I'm bought with a price, the blood of Jesus. Whom am I this morning? And you see, there's an identification crisis in the body of Christ today. We don't know who we are. If you know whom you are, who you belong to, your lifestyle is going to be different. Your character is going to be different. My God, it's time that the body of Christ come out from this place where you don't know whom you are. It deals with choosing the primary authority and audience for your life. Who pulls your string? Who is the primary authority in your life? Does your husband pull your string? Does your wife pull your strings? My God, does your boss pull your strings? And you know what I'm talking about. Because as believers in God, we submit to our bosses before we submit to God. We submit to, don't you know, today in the church, there are some husbands that can't come to church until the wife say go. There are some wives that can serve God until the husband gives authority. You think you want to trouble? You ain't got to nothing yet. You truly, you think you, Paul the Apostle, they brought him out in chains. Two guards on each side. This is the anointed of God. This is the servant of God. Brought out in chains. But my God, you might be in prison at the midnight hour. You might be in the midst of a fiery furnace. God is the one that is always there. He's always present to bring you out. You're going to make it, saints of God, if you hold to the everlasting arm of God. If God be for you, who can be against you? David said, I saw the Lord on my right hand that I should not be moved. He continually walked with me. The Lord is with you. This man of God was energized by the power of the Holy Spirit. I am crucified with Christ, he declared. Nevertheless, I live. Yet not I, but Christ that lives in me. And the life which I now live in the flesh, I live by faith of the Son of God who loved me and gave himself for me. In him I live and move and have my being this morning, energized by the power of God. Amen. Live in him. Agrippa and Paul, what a contrast. One of them in purple, the other in prison grabs. One on the throne, the other in shackle. One wears a crown, the other wears chains. Agrippa is a king, but in slavery or sin. Paul is chained, a prisoner, but rejoicing in the freedom of sin forgiven and the liberty that is in Christ. Agrippa is an earthly king who could not free Paul nor himself, but Paul was an ambassador of the king who had freed him from who called, who could free Agrippa from the damning effect of sin. My God, you don't have to be a king, but when you are ambassador of Christ, it's the Lord Jesus